Coming up, the holidays can be tough if you suffer from food allergies, but it doesn't have to be that way. When we come back, some fun ideas to keep you healthy and able to enjoy holiday treats without losing the taste. We'll be right back. And the holiday season means that we're eating a lot. But if you're like me and worried about overdoing it, or if you have food allergies and you have to worry about that, we have called in some help for us. Jill Motu from Zima's Madhouse Foods is here with some tips for all of us. And Jill and I were talking, it's the first time we're meeting. And you said this was something that you just had a passion for because it was a lifestyle you wanted to live. No food allergies in your family.
That's right. I have five kids. None of us have any dietary restrictions. This is more of an overall health and wellness lifestyle that I do for all of us. Mm-hmm. And then it segued into me creating a food line for my own kids that now I brought to market a few years ago.
Okay, we're talking gluten-free, chemical-free, and all of that stuff.
Yes.
Did your kids ever go, oh, Mom, this stuff tastes horrible? Come on, let's be honest.
Okay, there are some recipes they might not be, like, loving, but overall, I don't ever bring anything to the table unless it's past the five of them, and they are really tough.
So then that's why we know when we buy your stuff, it's going to be delicious.
Absolutely.
Okay, what are you making for us today?
So I brought two healthy, better-for-you recipes that are really holiday-inspired. And it's really hard for people to stay healthy during the holidays,
sure,
but I'm going to make it so easy for you.
Okay.
So the first one is a great breakfast. We're going to be making a cranberry relish that's going to go over coconut whipped cream on top of my sweet potato waffles.
Okay.
So the first thing we're going to do is take fresh cranberries. Mm-hmm. You can also use frozen. And here you're getting a lot of vitamins and minerals. It's just a lot of antioxidants.
Okay.
To that, we're going to add our pure maple syrup. We're gonna add a little bit of milk. Now I'm using almond milk, but you can use any milk of choice.
Okay.
Then to that I'm gonna add sugar. I use coconut palm sugar. You can use table sugar. I'm all about getting more nutrition out of your ingredients. Mm-hmm. So coconut palm sugar, even though it's sugar, it's still gonna give you some vitamins, some minerals, and it's going to give you a nice caramel tone, which really adds something special to the flavor of your recipe.
So you don't ever use regular sugar then, for the most part?
No, in fact, when my younger son comes home and with a new friend, he always says, Mom, this is Johnny. Johnny, this is my mom. We don't have white table sugar. I'm like, okay, not everybody cares. But
that's hilarious.
You can do an orange peel in here to just brighten up the cranberry flavor. But you can also use this orange extract with just a tiny bit, like an eighth of a teaspoon. Stir it in. This is going to cook for about 10 minutes. Mm-hmm. The cranberries are going to burst open. Mm-hmm. Your house is going to smell delicious. You've got a lot of big nutrients in here.
Okay.
Now, while this is setting up, I've got my coconut whipped cream. So just to show everybody, this is full fat coconut whipped cream in the can. You're gonna put it in your fridge overnight and the fat is gonna separate from the liquid. And the next day when you open it, you're gonna scoop out just the white solidified fat. It's healthy fat, don't be afraid of it.
So this is coconut milk then?
That's coconut milk.
Okay.
But you can buy coconut milk in a can and you can buy coconut milk in a carton. We want the can.
Okay.
And don't go light on it.
Really?
You gotta do the full fat or it won't separate.
Because of the full fat.
Yes.
Oh, interesting, okay.
So this is what the full fat looks like. Then you're gonna use a hand mixer or a stand-up mixer, add a little pure maple syrup, a little bit of vanilla, but also you could use your orange extract if you wanted to have an orange flavor. So we're going to take this, put it on my already made sweet potato waffles, and then we're going to add on our cranberry relish. And it is such a great holiday treat for your family. If you have family coming in town, this is surely going to impress them.
And you said that's a sweet potato version?
This is my sweet potato waffle mix.
Okay, very good. Well, believe it or not, we have run out of time. But you, I know, because we're having way too much fun.
I know, way too much fun.
But where can people go to get more information?
So you can go on my website at zimasfoods.com and you're going to find a chocolate avocado mousse that is to die for.
Okay. That's the one we didn't get to, but that one's on your website, so we'll get it in there. So thanks so much for coming in.
Thank you.
Happy holidays. I can't wait to try that. That sounds like that's going to be absolutely
delicious.
We appreciate it.